Thanks, Mike. Ladies and gentlemen, could you please be upstanding to receive our chief? Thank you. Malcolm, thanks. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Not too many formalities before the food is served, but I would like to take this opportunity right at the start of the function as President of the Clan MacLean Association in Western Australia to extend to you all a very cordial welcome to this luncheon in honour of our Chief, Sir Lachlan MacLean. Sir Lachlan, we are delighted that you accepted our invitation to visit Western Australia and trust that your time here and in Adelaide, Melbourne, Sydney and in New Zealand will all be most enjoyable, and we welcome you. May I also warmly welcome local members of our clan, other MacLeans and associated set names, and good friends of our members who have joined us today. We also gratefully acknowledge the presence of representatives of kindred clans and associations, including Clan MacLeod, that was the president with the loud voice that called you to order, Ian, Clan Donaghy, Clan Donald, Clan Munro, and the St Andrews Society of Western Australia. A very warm welcome to you all. I would like to take this opportunity to offer a few votes of appreciation, firstly to the council of our local association for assistance in planning for our chief's visit, and particularly the subcommittee who gave willingly of their time in preparing for our events and letting MacLeans in the community know of this special occasion. Our gratitude too to all members who donated door prizes today, and particularly to Maureen MacLean, who assembled the wonderful hamper, which is our first prize. May I also draw attention to this very special lectern cover. That's what we call it, I think. It was beautifully designed, crafted, and donated by our member, Malcolm Johnson. Thank you, Malcolm. I can't see you. Oh, yes, I can. Malcolm, thank you most sincerely on behalf of us all. And we really think it is appropriate that it is first displayed here today in the presence of our chief. Wonderful job. Well done. Thank you, Malcolm. And whilst passing thanks to our Malcolms, I would like to acknowledge our honorary piper, Malcolm, and thank you firstly for your stirring welcome to Sir Lachlan at Perth Airport on Thursday, which was appreciated not only by our chief but other Scots that came off the plane and thought you were there for them, so which is great. And for your piping yesterday and today, and also for organising the mini band that will entertain us later today. I'd also like to thank Malcolm very much for printing and help that he has given to us, and including our souvenir name badges designed and whatever you do through the duplicate dates me, but however they were done, they're very good. Thank you. And I would like to take the opportunity of, I'm getting all the thanks over up front so that all the focus after this will be on our chief. But I do take the opportunity to introduce and thank our mini band who will be entertaining us later this afternoon. As well as Malcolm, we can boast an all MacLean pipe corps, which I think is pretty unique perhaps for clan associations in this part of the world, in that we have Malcolm and his father on the pipes, and the Rankin brothers, Andrew and Duncan. And the pipers will be supported by drummers David Johnson and Jamie Hamilton, who have been regular supporters of our clan, and we thank you all again in advance of your performance. Thank you. We're also thankful, I'll leave that bit out, there's been a complication with the piano. Finally, and most importantly, I do want, on behalf of our local association and all of us gathered here today, to acknowledge the outstanding and tireless work carried out by our secretary, Kay McLean. Her efforts in publicising the chief's visit, organising functions, and attending to a whole range of related matters and details has been exceptional, and we're all most grateful, and I'd like you to carry that with acclamation. Thank you, Kay. And so, finally, I just take this opportunity at this stage to thank you once again for joining us today to celebrate the visit of Sir Lachlan to our city. There will be an opportunity again to meet our chiefs socially and personally later on this afternoon in the final hour of this function. And in the meantime, I invite you to enjoy the luncheon and our afternoon with our chief. Thank you. May I call on our past president and life member, Brian McLean, to offer the loyal toast. Thank you, Brian.
Please stand for the loyal toast. As usual, I forget my glass. I give you the Queen.
Thank you, Brian. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, as the food is being served, I draw your attention to our member Charles McLean, who will deliver the Selkirk Grace. Thank you, Charles.
Some who eat, but can eat, and some would eat that want it. We have meat, and we can eat, and so the Lord be thanked.
I have a very pleasing function to perform, and that is to... And it's a great honour too to propose a toast to our chief, the Honourable Sir Lachlan McLean, 28th Chief of the Clan and 12th Baronet of Duart and Morven. Each year, Sir Lachlan, we hold a luncheon or dinner on a date as close as possible to your birthday, and in your absence we propose this toast. To have you here in person today is very special for us, and we thank you sincerely for making the long journey to meet with McLean throughout Australia and New Zealand. We certainly hope and trust that this experience will be most enjoyable for you as it is for us. It is a hallmark of Sir Lachlan's time as chief that he reaches out to the worldwide family of McLeans and has sponsored many initiatives to bring us all closer together. The wonderful work and leadership Sir Lachlan provides starts at Duart Castle on the Isle of Mull. Sir Lachlan's great-grandfather, Sir Fitzroy, bought the castle in 1911 when it was an uninhabitable ruin which had been out of McLean's hands since the clan estates had been forfeited in 1691. Sir Fitzroy then set to and restored the castle. But today it is Sir Lachlan who has taken on the challenge and so successfully keeps Duart in good order. The chief and his team of helpers cater for thousands of visitors each year, many of whom are McLeans. Our chief is a man who believes in a very hands-on approach to running Duart Castle. You are just as likely to find him taking tours around the castle as weeding or painting the letterbox or hosting an evening reception for passengers off the Hebridean Prince's cruise ship. The work of both Sir Lachlan and his late wife, Lady Mary, was recognised when Duett Castle was awarded the Caledonia McBrayne Award for Excellence in Tourism in 2008. Beyond the castle, Sir Lachlan is patron and staunch supporter of the 11 geographically located Clanmaclean associations throughout the world. In addition, he has provided great encouragement to the use of modern technology to spread the word regarding our clan and our heritage. This has been achieved through the Clanmaclean website, maclean.org, if you want to access that for a lot of good information, and through MacLeanNet, which is deemed an association of the clan in its own right and has attracted attention from all corners of the globe. Sir Lachlan also guided the formation of the Clanmaclean International Association, in which he is very active as our chief, and is supported by clan chieftains, two honorary vice presidents, and the current presidents of the associations worldwide. To ensure that these structures and other clan activities are dynamic and appealing to Macleans in the community, our chief at the 2007 International Gathering on Mull requested that a working group be established to look at the future role of the associations, both terrestrial and web-based. A primary objective is to explore options to better retain and increase association membership and participation, with particular emphasis on attracting younger people. Sir Lachlan further suggested a project management board be formed to advance the terms of reference, and I'm pleased to report that our immediate past president, Margot Henshaw, accepted nomination to the board. The chief also chairs the Clanmaclean Heritage Trust, a very active group promoting and advancing the education of the public in the history and traditions of our clan. I know Sir Lachlan will refer to the work of the Trust later, but in this toast, I acknowledge again the wonderful leadership and encouragement that the chief provides to the Trust. We are thrilled that our association, being relatively small, has had a direct involvement in the administration of the Trust. Firstly, through the membership of our late member Alistair, and currently via the very active participation of our past president and inaugural life member, Brian McLean. There is so much more that could be said about our chief. We could, for example, refer to his service in the Scots Guards, his success in the corporate business world, and the fact that he has served and chaired the Board of Trustees of the Robertson Trust, an independent charitable Scottish trust dedicated to community-based care, health, education, art and sport. I would like, on behalf of our association and all of us here today, to congratulate you, Sir Lachlan, on your marriage in September to Rosemary, and please accept our very best wishes for a very happy future. We look forward to meeting you both on the Isle of Mull at the 2012 International Gathering. I conclude, Sir Lachlan, by again thanking you most sincerely for your acceptance of our invitation to visit us in Perth, and then to travel on as the guest of our kindred associations in the eastern states of Australia and New Zealand. I know from the program that has been organised by our kindred associations that Sir Lachlan will sleep well on the return flight with Emirates. It's a very, very busy program, particularly the last couple of weeks, but we hope that you thoroughly enjoy it and have a great time in the Southern Hemisphere. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please be upstanding to toast Sir Lachlan McLean, Chief of the Clan. Thank you, Ian. Thank you very much. Again, the Chief, this time I'll join you. I would now like to take this opportunity to call upon our immediate past President, Margot Henshaw, who has a pleasant duty to perform. Margot.
Dear Sir Lachlan, on behalf of the Clan MacLean Association of Western Australia, it's my great pleasure to present to you this beautiful book. It's titled The Adelaide Blizzard and records events in the life of the editor, Dr. Archibald Lang MacLean, when he was chief medical officer and bacteriologist with Sir Douglas Mawson's Antarctic expedition of 1911 to 1914. We hope that you enjoy this book and that in years to come it will bring back fond memories of your 2010 visit to your family here in Western Australia. Sir Lachlan, I give you this gift with our love.
Well, I certainly wasn't expecting that, and thank you very, very much. I was talking to Peter on the way over from Fremantle here that I was very worried about I thought I was going to be overweight with my luggage when I fly from Perth to Adelaide. I'll certainly be overweight now, I think, but that looks a marvellous book, and I won't open it now, but I will open it later on. So thank you all very, very much for that. That's very, very kind. And he's such a topical person at the moment with his work in the expedition as the chief medical officer. And I think one of the things that, I'm jumping about a bit in my speech, but I think one of the really interesting things that one finds out that there are so many MacLeans around the world who have done things or are doing things that none of us know about. We have at Dieert a montage produced by the first MacLean who was in space, who's a Canadian. And we had a man who'd been MacLean who'd been in space? Well, we had, and what's more, he's got there his badge, and he said about the first astronaut who landed on the moon, who was called Armstrong, that when he got out of the moon, instead of sticking in the flag of the United States first, he stuck in a flag of the Armstrong tartan. So whether that's true or not, I don't know, but I think it shows how much his clan meant to him. Firstly, most importantly, it's really nice to be back with you all in Western Australia, and a lot of familiar faces from 1997. We all look a bit older and balder, well, not everyone, but some of us do. But it's really nice to see you all, and some of you that I've actually met at Dieert, including young Scott MacLean, who proposed to his now wife in the sea room at Dieert, and I remember that as well. So there's some of you I've met there and some of you I've met here, so it's really nice to see you. And I would like to thank Peter and Kay, who really organised the programme. When I was here in 97, when I got home, I thought I probably needed a liver transplant, because the hospitality had been so good, and if it continues like it's been so far, I'll definitely need one when I get back this time.